Hello students and welcome in the online session of class 8 science chapter 6 combustion and flame. This is the first video of the lesson. So let's see which topics will be covered today. So we'll do combustion, then one activity related to it. Then we'll learn about ignition temperature, how do we control the fire and the different types of combustions. So let's start with the first slide, that is what is combustion. So as we know, when coal burns in air, it produces carbon dioxide, heat and light. So this is a general process that whenever something is burnt in presence of air, it gives off heat and light. Okay, so now when we are saying that when coal is burned, so coal is made up of carbon. So in this case, carbon dioxide is also burned. Okay, like nowadays we have heaters, but in the olden days, some sigdis were used in which the coal was burned. Okay, and the coal after burning releases CO2 gas, then heat and light also. So a chemical process in which a substance reacts with oxygen to give off the heat is called combustion. Now this is the definition for combustion, that whenever a substance, it is a process. Okay, combustion is a chemical process. When we say chemical, that means definitely there will be some change. Definitely there will be a new substance formed after combustion. It's a chemical change. So it's that process in which a substance reacts with oxygen. Okay, we all know that for combustion, for burning, oxygen gas is required. So when a substance reacts with oxygen, it burns and it gives off heat. And that chemical process is called combustion process. Fine. I hope the definition is clear to you all. Once again, I'll repeat for you. The chemical process in which the substance reacts with the oxygen and it gives off heat is called combustion. Okay. So now the substance that undergoes combustion means the substance which is burning in presence of oxygen or which is reacting with oxygen is known as the combustible substances. Means the substances which can catch fire, which can burn in presence of oxygen, they are known as combustible substances. Okay. And in common, in local language, we also call them as fuel. Okay. We all know that fuels burn, they give out heat energy, light energy. Okay. So fuel is a combustible substance. Combustible substance in local language, okay, in common way it is called as fuel only. Now the combustible substances or the fuel can be solid, liquid or gas. It can be a solid fuel, it can be a liquid fuel or it can be a gaseous fuel. Fine. Like very good example is like we humans eat the food to get the energy. So for our body, the fuel is our food because this food is burned in presence of oxygen. You know, when we breathe, we take oxygen inside. So what is the function of that oxygen? That oxygen goes to each and every cell of the body. That food is burned in each and every cell in presence of oxygen and the energy is released outside along with the CO2. So that CO2 is given out of the body and that energy which is released is used to do our daily functions. Okay. So this food is acting as a fuel in our body. It provides us energy. In our body, food is broken down by the reaction with oxygen and the heat is generated. Okay. Now, oxygen in the air is essential for combustion. So you must remember that oxygen is the main requirement for combustion. Without oxygen, combustion is not possible. And during the process of combustion, heat and light are given out. This is another important point, that whenever there is a combustion, whenever the combustible substance is reacting with oxygen, it definitely will give heat and light energy. Okay, so in the picture also you can see some examples of combustible substances, like coal can burn easily in presence of oxygen, so it's a combustible substance. Then wood also burns in presence of oxygen, so this is also a combustible substance. Then non-combustible, sand is non-combustible, sand cannot catch fire. Okay, then stones also, they are non-combustible, they cannot be burned. Okay, they cannot react with oxygen to give us heat and light. So they are non-combustible substances. Now, let's move on to the next slide and see one of the activity. So in the activity, you can see here that three different setups are shown here. Fine. So in the first setup, there is a candle which is burning and this is covered with the glass jar. But here you can see there are some wooden rods kept. Okay, wooden kept rod, and on this wooden rod this jar is kept. That means there is space here for the air to go inside. Fine. Now in the second one, the wooden rods are removed and you can see now the glass jar is kept directly on the candle like this. And in the third one, there is a glass plate over the jar in which the candle is there. Fine. So now what is observed here, that air is very much necessary for combustion, right? So in the first case, what will happen, that there is a space for the air to enter. So when air can enter the chimney from below, so what will happen, the candle continues blowing, okay, the flame continues blowing because the air is coming from this side, so there is proper supply of oxygen, so candle will continue burning. But in case B, when the air does not enter, okay, so there may be little space somewhere, until the air goes it will burn, but after some time what will happen, it will, when the air is not coming from outside, this will stop, this will first flicker, okay, flicker means it, the flame will move here and there and then it gets off and it will produce some smoke because the air supply is not proper, okay, very little air is going inside. So there is no air supply, so it will flicker and it will also gets off. And in the third case, the flame finally goes off because the air is not available. Here you can see that from upside also it is covered, right? And what will happen from downside also it is covered, so it will goes off only. Now this one you can see here that from upside is it is open. Fine, so it is open, that means now after some time, because from downside the air is not coming, okay. So it will flicker and it will go off, fine. But here from both the sides it is covered. So what will happen? The flame will definitely go off as the air is not available at all. Okay. Now the next slide is ignition temperature. So ignition temperature is a very important topic, that this temperature is the lowest temperature at which a substance catches fire. Okay, that temperature at which a substance catch fire, that temperature is called the ignition temperature. So every fuel has a ignition temperature. Okay, every fuel has its ignition temperature. As you can see, if you are taking a nylon cloth, it will catch fire very soon. But if you'll take a cotton cloth, it catches fire after some time. So every material will catch fire only when its ignition temperature will come. So ignition temperature is the lowest temperature at which a substance catches fire. Okay, the substance which have very low ignition temperature can easily catch the fire. Okay, any substance whose ignition temperature is low, that means at very low temperature it will catch fire. Okay, so it easily catches fire, and such substances are called inflammable substances. Okay, substances which have a very low ignition temperature, which can burn themselves at a very low temperature, they are called inflammable substances. Okay, like you might have seen, whenever there is a vehicle going taking oil or petrol or diesel in it, okay, those trucks which are carrying the oil or petrol or diesel, so on that it is very clearly written in big letters that this is an inflammable material. Okay, so keep a proper distance. So inflammable means it catches fire very soon because its ignition temperature is very low. Fine. And how can you define the ignition temperature? The lowest temperature at which a substance catches fire. Okay, so the substances which easily catch fire at very low temperature, they are called inflammable substances. For example, petrol catches fire very easily, alcohol catches fire very quickly, and then liquefied petroleum gas. Okay, the gas which is present in our houses, in the cylinders, is LPG, liquefied petroleum gas. So you can see very easily that when you switch on the burner and just use the lighter, so it immediately catches fire. So its ignition temperature is very low and they can easily catch the fire. So they are inflammable substances. Here in the diagram also you can see some materials are given along with their ignition temperatures. Like white phosphorus, it catches fire at 35 degrees Celsius. Petrol catches fire at 246 degrees Celsius. Okay. Kerosene catches fire at 220 degrees Celsius. Diesel 210. Wood 300. Coal 454. Coal takes time to catch fire. Then piece of paper 233 degrees Celsius. So these are their ignition temperature. Till they get ignition temperature, they will not catch fire. So that much temperature has to be provided to them so that they can catch the fire. Okay. Now, how do we control the fire? If there is fire somewhere, how can we control it? So now you know that oxygen is very necessary for combustion, right? So if you cut the supply of oxygen, then the fire can be controlled. Okay, this is very important point. If we cut the supply of oxygen, then the fire can be controlled. Okay, like there will be a substance, then there is air. Okay, when they combine together, and if there is supply of, you know, temperature. Fine, yahan se temperature, then here oxygen, and this is the combustible or inflammable substance, suppose. When they three mix together or when they three combine together, there will be definitely combustion, right? So how the fire can be controlled? So one thing, either you remove the oxygen from here, you cut the supply of oxygen, right? Or you reduce the temperature, or you remove the inflammable substance from that place. So these are the three ways by which the fire can be controlled. Fine. First thing is remove the oxygen, cut the supply of oxygen. Second, reduce the temperature. Okay. And third, remove the inflammable substance from there. Then only the fire can be controlled. If the three are in contact with each other, the fire cannot be controlled. Fine. So now fire brigade pours water on the fire. Okay. So we use water to pour off the fire. Water cools the combustible substance. So what is the function of water here? When water falls on the combustible substance, inflammable substance, then water cools the temperature. So that one point which I discussed with you now, that the temperature has to be reduced. So water is doing that thing here. Okay, so water is cooling the combustible substance so that its temperature is brought below its ignition temperature, so that the material gets very cool and the material will not get the ignition temperature and it will stop burning. And in this way the fire can be controlled. Okay, and the water vapors, when you put water on any burning material, so water vapors will be formed, steam will be formed. So these water vapors, what they are doing, they are surrounding the combustible material and they are cutting the supply of air. So those water vapors will come in between the combustible substance and the oxygen. So the supply of the oxygen is also cut here. So the fire is extinguished, and in this way the fire can be controlled. Okay, so I think now it is very clear to you that why we are using water, because water will cool down the temperature of the combustible substance below the ignition temperature, and the water vapors which comes out, they will also cut the supply of the air, and in this way the fire can be controlled. Okay, so what can we conclude? That there are three essential requirements for producing fire. So for a fire we need three things. First is we need the fuel, the substance which will burn. Then we need the air. Okay, and then we need temperature or the heat. Why we need heat now? To raise the ignition temperature, to bring the ignition temperature of the substance, because the substance will not burn till the ignition temperature will be reached. So we need three things. We need fuel, we need air, and we need heat to increase the temperature also. And fire can be controlled by removing one or more of these requirements. So either of these three, if we remove any one, then the fire can be controlled. Fine. So this is the concept behind that, how fire can be controlled. Fire can be controlled if you cut the supply of air, if you remove the fuel from the place, and if you reduce the temperature, if you reduce the heat from that place, then only the fire can be controlled. Okay. So you can see here, if these three meet together, then there will be burning. So how can we control? We can control if we remove the heat from there. By using water, we can reduce the temperature. If we remove the fuel from there, if the combustible material is only removed from the place. Okay, now suppose there is the fire in the grass over there, dry grass. So if we remove the other dry grasses from the place, then the fire can be controlled. Otherwise, the other dry things will also catch fire and the fire will continue burning. And if we cut the supply of oxygen, then also it is very possible to control the fire. Okay, so I think the concept is clear now, how we control the fire. Now next is the different types of combustions. Now you can see here three different types of combustion. One is rapid combustion, then spontaneous combustion, and third one is explosion. I repeat again, first is rapid combustion. Okay, very quick combustion. Then spontaneous means sudden combustion, suddenly the fire starts. And third one is the explosion. Okay, blast. So a combustion that takes place rapidly with a very high speed. Okay, that is called the rapid combustion. Like we just on the burner, give a lighter and the fire starts burning. So this is the rapid combustion. Okay, very quickly the combustion starts and the fire starts burning. That is rapid combustion. Then second is spontaneous. Spontaneous means suddenly. So the type of combustion in which a material suddenly burst into flames. Okay, there is no reason behind, but suddenly its ignition temperature raised and it starts burning. And that is called a spontaneous combustion. Okay, then third one is explosion. So the process of combustion in which a large number of gases are evolved with the production of tremendous amount of heat, light and sound. So the combustion in which the gases or the material burns such that it gives a lot of heat, light along with the sound also, then it calls a combustion. Now you can see here firecrackers. Fine, so firecrackers, when they burn, so they give a huge sound, light and heat. So that is called an explosion. Okay, bomb blast. So that is also an example of explosion. Here you can see it is the, you know, white phosphorus which is burning. So white phosphorus, as we have discussed in the table backside, that its ignition temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, so in summer season what happens? Our temperature raises up to 40, 42, 43, 44 like that. So this white phosphorus starts spontaneously burning. Okay, because its ignition temperature has reached. Its ignition temperature is 35 degree. Fine. But if the temperature outside in the environment becomes more than this 35 degree, then this white phosphorus start automatic burning. And that is called the spontaneous combustion. Okay, because its ignition temperature is very low, and outside in the environment, if the temperature is more than the ignition temperature, then this material will start burning spontaneously, suddenly. And that is the spontaneous combustion. Example is white phosphorus. Okay, so this is all about what we have learned today. So today we have learned what is combustion. That is the process in which the material burns or reacts in presence of oxygen and heat and light is given out is called combustion. Then in the activity you have seen that air is very necessary, that means oxygen is very necessary for combustion. Then what is ignition temperature? The lowest temperature at which the material starts burning is ignition temperature. Lower the ignition temperature, more quickly the material starts burning. Then how to control the fire? We know that there are three methods to control the fire: either to cut the supply of oxygen, then to remove the material from the place, and third, to reduce the heat. Okay, if the heat is reduced, temperature is reduced, then also the fire can be controlled. Okay, you know, when somebody's body get fire, okay, somebody is burning, suppose some human body is burning, suppose, so we generally use blankets to cover that human. Why we are using blankets that time? Because blanket cuts the supply of air. And if your clothes have suddenly caught fire, then we should not run. Because if the person is running, that what will happen? If you are running, you are more in contact with the air. Fine, you are more in contact, there is more supply of oxygen, and the burning, the fire will increase at that time. Fine, so if any person's clothes have caught fire, then they should either roll on the ground so that the supply of oxygen will be cut, or any blanket can be used to cover the body so that again the supply of oxygen can be cut and the fire can be controlled. Then we have seen three different types of combustions. Okay, rapid combustion means a very quick combustions. Then spontaneous combustion means sudden combustions where the material's ignition temperature has reached and the material suddenly starts burning. And then explosion, in which when the material burns, a lot of heat, light and sound energy are given out. That is called explosion. Okay, so that's all about today's video. In the next video, we'll continue with the next topics. Till then, all of you stay home and stay safe, and do read the lesson from your textbook. Okay, so we'll meet next time. Till then, goodbye everyone.